my tribute to Emmett Leith and then on to Dennis Shook via pictures. But I want to first tell you something that I would not say in publicly if Emmett Leith were alive, because if he hears me tell it, he would get very angry at me. When we start holding our conferences, symposia in Lake Forest, of course, he was the honorary chairman, and we don't want him to have to pay a registration fee. So he sent a check to us, and we sent it right back to him. Then he sent it right back to us again. He says, I donate this to your artist support fund. And he did that for each and every symposia. It's the first time I publicly tell you this fact. Okay. He's that kind of a person. Now, the pictures I'm showing, let me see where we're. This series of pictures is due to one other participant. He's a photographer, so he took a lot of pictures in 1991. His name is Carlos Vertanician from Argentina. He went everywhere the group went during the convention in 1991 in Lake Forest, took these pictures, and I got them because I was lecturing in South America, and he gave me these pictures. So about 10% of them come from my collection at the college, because when Dennis Shook first came to America in 1989, his first stop was Lake Forest. And the president of Lake Forest College gave him a big reception in our guest house, attended by trustees, very important people. And it was not during a convention, so there were very few holographers during that welcome presidential party. So I have pictures of that, okay? So in random order of these pictures taken by Vertanician, this gives you the flavor of of our program some more, but there are a lot of pictures of the big three, Dennis Shook, Emmett Leith, and Benton. So I will do this quickly. So those of you in Lake Forest, you remember the tavern that we went to, yes. The Lantern, the gathering place. Beautiful Lake Forest beach, spent many million dollars, completely scientifically designed and created. Picnic area with fireplace. Now there's a library in there so you can borrow books to read. This is sign-off from Bulgaria. Now here they are in the convention. The first one, Dennis Shook participated. They were co-chair of the convention. Emmett Leith joined in again. Here's the middle is the man, Carlos, who took all these pictures. Here, usually after convention's over, I invite them to a Chinese dinner, sometimes to Chinatown, and give them the so-called wedding dinners with 10 courses all evening. Well, here's Ginny, Benton's wife, and Emmett and June, and Nick Phillips there. They still got some noodles on the plates. And now I want to tell you something about June. She used to go everywhere with Emmett. So when Emmett is in going to all the sessions, what does June do? It turns out that she goes to graveyards and then local libraries. She's studying genealogy of her family. One summer, we even went into Wisconsin, in which she located a distant relative in a grave in the next state. By doing research, all the time we have meetings. So she's not doing nothing, okay? He's standing next to our 36 Nikon scanning camera, producing holograms of a group picture. I have an extra few. I'm going to give one to the archive here and to Monday's collection and maybe to our historian. It's we make four color stereo holograms, and so he was very interested. Here he's giving the lectures. Again, each time he always give papers. Looking at my collection in a hallway in the college. Here's Sharon McCormick, the professional windsurfer that I in. Right. And here we are gathering. Oh, here is a picnic on the beach. Take a camera angle is toward the land side. His wife there, and very relaxed. That's in my summer house. I am very famous for cooking steak. Everybody loves my steak. Let me show you. Well, these are mixed order. We'll come back to the steak and the story on Danny Sue. Okay. Oh, here's, guess who? Melissa Crenshaw. He curated that particular show. There's another story. In the first session, Monday morning, we are in the auditorium starting, and then there's a big thunderstorm, and the power was out. We were inside a dark room. You can't see anybody. So immediately, we had a solution. We moved to the college chapel, which has stained windows with no light necessary. And we really learned to like that. Here's Danny Silk there. After an hour of the introductory to everyone, the sunshine, not a cloud in the sky. So that's a perfect place to take a group picture. Later, during the art exhibition, that's when we do the camera scan and record the stereo hologram, which is in inside cover of every issue of SPIE publication. After our third symposium, we invited SPIE to publish it. It's too much work for Mrs. Christ. Here's more pictures in another exhibition. Dennis Shook then participated, of course. Here in my summer house, and in every picture, you will see him holding a Budweiser, okay? They did not sponsor anything. Oh, here is Setsuko and Professor Lee, and the lake behind. And you should see Yuri Waterski. He's a bear of a man. A little bit stoop, but you'll be amazed how strong he is. He said he skis with his son. And in another occasion, Nick Phillips get on a tube, and I don't know how he managed it. I merely dragged him around on a tube, and he got black and blue all over his body. That's Nick Phillips, a little side light here. And during the exhibition, again, we have a party. And here he gives the familiar Russian dog there in his drawings. By the way, during his first visit in an off year for our conference, 89, he did give a public lecture in which we gather all the local holographer and other people. There he said the first time he publicly told about how he thought of holography as described more in detail by historian Sean Johnston. He told, and I asked him to write it up. So that story was published in our proceedings in 91. More pictures of just a group photograph. Here is my windsurfing buddy here, Sasha Larkins. He stayed a month in my summer house. My wife couldn't kick him out. He's not here, so I can say that. We were going on vacation. He doesn't want to leave. And I didn't mind. He windsurfed with me. We have races around the little island every day. This is in Lake Forest. That's a repeat. The pictures Carlos took include the environment, the Lake Forest College, So this will add to the vignette of the experience for you here of our previous symposia. This is the building, the physics building, and the auditorium that we have conferences across the terrace. More Lake Forest College, Lake Forest City. And here a busy workshop afterwards, everybody come around. Here's Niels. You know what he's doing? He glued a mirror on the wall and used it as one of the mirrors in an interferometer. And he would go and push against the wall, and you will hear the squeaking sound from the shifting fringes and know how much the wall moved. That's the kind of guy I learned a lot from. I use this all the time to demonstrate interferometry. Here's Niels. That's his interferometer right there, one of the mirrors on the wall. He just used clay dough and stick it there. Here's Professor Lee from Korea. Virginia, again, my secret for running conferences. And look how hungry Mr. Lee was. Nick Phillips and Benton. Guess who this was? Pal Grigas. Everywhere he goes, he lies flat on his back and took a 360-degree photograph with a Pal lens. Okay. Here's Richard Rollison. He teaches every workshop diagrammatic gelatin. Just a panoramic view of the classroom. A lot of us who teach there try to attend every one of those to learn something else besides our own specialties. That's Ed Wesley, my chief assistant. Oh, this is repeated before. He's really studying the system. Here's Ginny, Benton's wife, walking the beach, with the yacht being loaded behind him, giving lectures. Oh, look here, Markov. Danny Silk. I hear that every morning, Dennis should get up really early, walk to the lake and swim before everything starts. Okay. And I want to see a closer up. This volleyball on the beach and so forth. Oh, that's me with my famous stick. Everybody want to visit me because of my stick, especially Niels Abramson. He like it with corn. Danny Hsu, on the other hand, would give it back to me. I said, why don't you like steak? He said, I like it, but it's rare. It's pink. I have to burn it before he wants to eat it. He likes steak burned. If it's still soft, he won't eat it. Lots of steak, okay? It's Markov and... here I'm using a jigsaw with a rope and a strobe light to demonstrate interference in making reflection holograms, standing waves. Now we are lined up again, just like in the previous symposium, in front of the art gallery to make more trouble. By the way, the stereogram. This is the hologram that I'm still looking for. It's a hologram made with a DuPont photopolymer supplied to me in liquid form by Dr. Bruce Booth. And I just pour it with tapes around and make at least 50 microns thick hologram. And amazingly, this transmission hologram can be seen very sharply with white light because the big, thick, bright angle. So somebody please invent this again because we should have full color transmission holograms. Okay. Now, here again, with Carlos Vertonghen. By the way, he's having a traveling full-time holographic exhibition all across South America. And everywhere he benefits me because somebody got really interested and invited me down to lecture about it. So I get nice trips that way. Here I'm showing a hologram that Dennis Shook gave me right now in retrospect, invaluable hologram before we met. He sent me an inlaid box containing holograms of the treasures of Kremlin with a hand-carved lamb. I showed it to many people in my conference before. And this is a jewelry in gold color, perfect for using the Soviet emotion. Everybody showing holograms to each other. Who left me? I'm trying to teach people to windsurf on the beach. But she's much better than me, but she could not handle my sails. My sails were too elementary. When she sails, she doesn't even need a rope. Only in high winds, the wind blows the sail up and pulling yourself up with it, called water starring. We don't do that in the Midwest. Not enough wind. Now, this, I got a story behind. Okay, what is this? This is taken during the presidential reception for him. In my lab, he picked up this danger laser sign and put it against himself. But before I tell you the punchline, let me go to another story. I ran into him, of course, in the Benton Tribute. We arrived to celebrate his living, you know, the tribute. But the night we arrived, he died. So the tribute became the memorial. And more than 100 people showed up from all around the world. And so I went to him and I said, Yuri, you know, at that time he was married to a young Italian woman. So I consulted with him, Yuri, what's your secret? He whispered to my ear, he says, eat lots of hot pepper. I know it was a joke because Yuri, I tried that, it doesn't work. Now, this worked. He's holding this, he kept this from my lap and took a picture with it. He says, maybe this will make me look dangerous and and girls will notice me more. And guess what? It works. Right away. You're talking about this is the director of Russian studies in Lake Forest College. But he's that kind of a man, very humorous and very serious. When we were just relaxing in my summer house, guess what he was reading? He was reading the Russian translation of my favorite Chinese novel, Dream of the Red Chambers. He's widely read. Showing holograms. So that's it. You give another vignette of experience and the two great men. Thank you.